Hi everyone, I'm Greg Heschley at ACT, a lead engineer here in the product development group. I'm going to be talking to you today about high K plates. So a high K plate is basically a heat pipe embedded plate. So we embed our heat pipes into typically aluminum plates, but can be other materials. The heat pipes improve the conduction enhancement of the plate. This can be used in a number of different ways. First way we're going to look at it is for a heat sink. So let's imagine we have a heat sink here. So this is this would be the back side of the heat sink. We have, let's say, two heat loads here and here. So if we're looking at kind of the down shot of this, this would kind of look like this, right? Imagine there are fins in the back side here. So what we do, without heat pipes in this heat sink, the heat is basically just going to spread out across that base plate through the conduction of the base plate material, typically aluminum. By embedding heat pipes into this, we can embed heat pipes. Let's say we embed a couple of heat pipes like this, and like this. We can then use those heat pipes to spread that heat out across the entire base plate. That's going to isothermalize this base plate and improve its performance. The other case we can look at for high K plates is where we have a heat sink or a heat source that's kind of far away from the heat sink, right? And so we're traditionally just relying on that conduction to move the heat from one side to another. So in this case, we're just gonna have a simple plate. This is especially true with like VPX style cards, where we'd have a heat load here in the middle, and then we'd have our cooling rails along the edge, right? So just like in the heat sink case, what we would do is we would take our heat pipes and you draw them across the heat input area. And now the heat pipes, as the heat is being put in here, heat gets transferred to those two edges to improve the conduction gradient across the card. So those are kind of the basics of a high K plate and how you can embed heat pipes into a plate. How we do that typically here at ACT is we either use a thermally conductive epoxy or a solder. We embed that in there and can get typically pretty close to the original geometry of your card.
Thanks for watching an episode of Engineers with Markers. We'd appreciate if you like this video and subscribe to our channel. Then make your way on down to the description for more resources. If you've got a question, leave it in the comments or visit the contact page on our website to talk with an engineer. From everyone at ACT, your thermal experts, stay cool.